So the first time that I met EverEvolve, I was opening up for Davies, and it was January in Chicago at the Patio Theater, and the show was fucking freezing. They had no heat on in the show. I have no idea why. Did not turn out well.
Man, that Davies show was a minute ago. I gotta say a few years now. It was super freezing in that building. I don't think I took my coat off the entire night. I think us and Asthmatic were probably some of the only rappers that didn't rap over their lyrics that night.
At this show was having a good time. It was just absolutely miserable. You could see your own breath. But EverEvolve came on stage and everybody forgot about the weather for that 1 second. While they were on, they were throwing mannequin heads into the crowd. They really brought the energy into it and seemed to get everybody involved. And that's when I was like, oh, who are these people? I gotta check them out.
And then what, we had the Cameron show at Joe's on Wee Street. And ironically, fast forward, we had Joe's at Rosemont for Redman. But even at the Cameron show, my boy Asthmatic came through with that fire. He always starts with that Biggie instrumental, and people look at him like he's crazy because he's a white boy rapping over that, but always gets the crowd hype off that, so I rock with that.
It wasn't until like a month later when I was opening up for Cameron, and then I saw Rhymester again. And I said, what's up to him backstage? And I was like, yo, what's going on, man? I think you guys are dope. We should link up. He's like, yeah, you should come to the studio sometime. And I don't know, most of the time when you talk to people and you say that, it's all talk. But whatever, that I think that next day I might have been in EverEvolve studio. And we made If I Left the Game, which is the last song on Jazz Cigarette Part 1.
I'm in no hurry.
Yeah, let's go to the studio or let's link up. And nah, you never see them again. Or you do see them and they just have brand new. But no, we definitely linked up. Went crazy. If I Left the Game, first track to make together, but last track on Jazz Cigarette Part 1. Super dope sample in the beginning of that crazy announcement.
So we made that track, and I think I had Rhymester then on the podcast.
Ill-Advised and Prepared, the greatest podcast you never heard. I'm the guest of the year. Shout out to those guys, all of them.
The next week, and then I was doing a show with them the next week after that. So within a week of meeting him, I had done 3 things with Rhymester. And then I soon realized that he was doing that with 8 different other people. And I was like, the guy doesn't ever stop working. So we started doing, I don't know,
all the videos we made. Hayward, BBE. I say Asthmatic, one of them Duker, the 2 coldest white boys in Chicago. White Men Can Rap, that's the next project. Jazz Cigarette, shout out to Fafa. It's like we're both hip-hop heads. And when we came together with that project, Asthmatic already had just a folder of just jazzy beats. I had a few in the chamber. 100,000 came through.
Let's try to make this work. We work well together. The only time we could ever figure out our schedules together would be in the mornings, because EverEvolve is always bumping with people. So I come in every morning, I have a blunt and I have some iced coffee ready for him. Rhymes would be like pretty pissed off that I was there this early, and we then slowly start to make some music.
But I feel that we're 2 MCs and just, I don't know, we just embody that spirit of hip-hop all the way. And you know, we don't stop with it, we keep it going. And even in today's music, that may not necessarily be the main sound, but there's an audience out there that, you know, digs it, that can vibe with it.
Jazz Cigarette 1 came together, and it took a long time, but the finished product was awesome. And then Part 2, we decided, well, it went so well, it seemed to resonate with people. Iced coffee and blunts just did so well. We're like, all right, let's make sure we let's run it back. So I think part two is a little bit different. I think it's more so, if you look at it, it'd be like part one could be before you have your caffeine, and then part two is after you have your caffeine. It's a little bit more up tempo and a little bit more lively, but it's a dope project, and it took almost just as long, I think, maybe to make it, but I love the way the first one turned out, so I think that this is the way the second one will turn out as well.
Gotta take it back to those speakeasy days, those 1920 days. That's what this Jazz Cigarette project reminds me of. Part one, it's like a warm up. You know, it's like a preview to a movie. And then part two, it's just, to me, it's a cinematic. The way we spit and the way this production came about. Shit, that might even be a part three. We don't know yet. By Asthmatic Rhymester, Five Hakeem Singing, Ever Evolve Studios, Vinyl Digital.